mi głupi je
Turkish woman Jale heard the Ukrainian language for the first time several years ago. At the time, she became determined to learn it.
This is my second university. I heard about the opening of a Ukrainian language and literature department in the news. It interested me very much. I was also influenced by the fact that relations between Turkey and Ukraine are developing, both in trade and in the political sphere.
For Turks, learning Ukrainian is an opportunity to establish business contacts in Ukraine and develop local tourism.
For the third year in a row, we are enrolling 20 students in our department. They come here to study and learn about Ukraine and become the first Turkish specialists in the Ukrainian language.
Ukrainian language became popular in Turkey after the events of 2014, the Revolution of Dignity in Kyiv, the annexation of Crimea, and Russian aggression in the Donbas. In Turkey, it is possible to study Ukrainian at both higher educational institutions and at extracurricular Saturday schools.
It became necessary for direct communication between Turkish academics and officials in Ukraine. Communication was supposed to take place without the use of a third language, but directly in Turkish or Ukrainian.
Studying at higher education institutions is partially financed from the Turkish budget, while Saturday schools are financed by Ukraine.
When children come to our school, they are completely immersed in Ukrainian culture. It is very important that the development of these schools is supported by Ukraine, and there is support at the state level.
Students and pupils study both the language and the culture. They sing songs, read literature, and dive deep into art.
The children wanted to work on drama. We suggested translating works by Ukrainian playwrights and performing them on the Turkish stage. They said they wanted something new. They believe there are many interesting works in Ukraine.
Jale was one of the first to take Ukrainian language course at Istanbul University. She says the beginning was the most difficult. The alphabet was quite hard to learn, but the real challenge was phonetics.
Perhaps this does not mean anything, but the word domohospodarka, or housewife, was extremely difficult for me. But I really liked it, and it began to resemble a song. At home, my daughter and I love to sing this word.
Turkish students are able to hear how the Ukrainian language sounds and practice it through exchange programs between the two countries. Reported by Jafer Umerov and Nedia Kataman, UATV.